Today is a very lazy Saturday. I'm on the couch. It's raining outside. I actually get married in less than a week, so my mind is all over the place, so I opted to do nothing today. That's some pretty heavy breathing, Chili. I'm making my fourth cup of coffee today, and it's almost 3 p.m., so that's gonna be fun. Probably gonna be up all night, but oh well. Okay, hello. Oh, my coffee. Oh, okay. This coffee mug has coffee stains, but this is my favorite mug. I don't know if you can see. It's like Alice in Wonderland, but I got it in a tea shop in London, and it's my favorite. Cheers. And before we get started on today's video, I know people are gonna ask me questions on what sweater this is and where I got it. I will link the description of this sweater below so that anybody wants it, you can get it. I love this sweater. The holidays are coming up. It's a perfect gift idea for someone else. It's also a perfect gift idea for yourself. Today's video is all about gear, specifically my gear from the Pacific Crest Trail. A question that the thru hiking community loves is, what is your base weight? And if you don't know, base weight in the thru hiking community is basically how much does your pack weigh without consumables and the clothes and shoes that you were actually wearing. It's a funny joke though, because technically you're wearing all of it because it's in your pack and you're wearing your pack, but that's beside the point. If you hear a lot of weird noises, Chili is right here just scratching himself, licking himself, making weird grunting noises. So just disregard, it's not me. It's probably not me. However, I didn't know my base weight before I started the trail, and if you've watched any of my videos, you know that I've said I didn't really care. I just had the gear that I had, and it felt pretty good to me, and that's all I actually cared about. However, I decided to create my own little lighter pack link, and this will be put in the description below, so you can just click on it and basically see everything I'm about to talk about. Lighter pack is this link slash website sort of thing that anybody can use. It's completely free, and you can input all of your gear and everything else, and then you can put in the weight and the price and various other things if you want, so you can see how much everything cost and weighed. People generally use it just for weight purposes, and then they share it with other hikers and whatever. I decided to make my own lighter pack link, and with that, you know, I put in all of the weight and the price of every item, and we're gonna just dive right in. Okay. All right, we can do this. We can get it together. I just know it. This is my lighter pack link. It's really nice. You can do this as well if you go to this link, you know, you can kind of hover over these different categories. So here I have clothing and shoes, and if I double tap it, it's really interesting because then it just has all the items of clothing and shoes broken down. And if I click over here, you know, my camp shoes, it's saying they were 10 ounces. Over here, my regular shoes were 14.8 ounces, and you can kind of see how it's broken down. I don't really care so much about that, but, or you double tap on the circle itself and it just goes back to the big picture. And on the right here, we have, you know, the category of everything that I've broken down, and then the price and the weight. As a disclaimer, when we go to look at this link, I have the price of every single item. Even if I purchased this item years before before I thru-hiked the Pacific Crest Trail. So it doesn't mean I spent this all right up front, but this is just how much everything cost me. I went back into all my receipts. That was just the easiest thing for me. And you will see that these prices are from when I purchased them, and I included links to every item. So if you go to that link, the price might be different. Sometimes I saw that it was lower. Sometimes I saw that it was higher. My price listed here is the price of when I ordered it. As for all of the weight, I was as accurate as possible. I went to the actual like item description on the brand's website of that item and looked at how much it said it weighed. I didn't weigh these things myself. This is just from the internet. So I'm hoping that most of this is correct. So as you can see, it said that my total cost of every single thing of gear, including all of the gear that I replaced on the trail, came out to $5,249.46. You can see that right here. And then obviously it listed what each total price was from each category. Now on my weight, I put everything into ounces. With my base weight, you can see that I came out to 231.71 ounces. Now this comes in handy. I can change the unit and I can go to pounds. So I came to 14.48 pounds for my base weight. I'm gonna switch this back to ounces and we are gonna go through everything. We're actually gonna go all the way to the bottom. And this is because I included some pre-hike items. As you can see, there are a lot of books and research material that may or may not be helpful to someone who wants to plan their own through hike of the Pacific Crest Trail. This item I think is really cool. I'm gonna actually open this up. It is a National Geographic map of the Pacific Crest Trail. They also have them for other trails. I actually bought it for my family and I bought an extra one for myself, but brought it to work so that my family and my coworkers could, you know, keep tabs of me along the way. So I included that here. There's a PCT data book with, you know, mileages, landmarks, facilities. Another great one is Yogi's PCT handbook. This book here is about how to mentally prepare for the PCT. This is an autobiography of a thru-hiker's journey on the Pacific Crest Trail. This is another one of my favorites. It's like a coffee table book. I mean, that's what I called it. I also bought this for my family. It basically just has some beautiful pictures of the PCT along with, you know, just information. Not information that's really gonna help you plan your through hike, but just fascinating information about how the Pacific Crest Trail came to be, the different sections, and it's paired with some beautiful images throughout the entire trail. Here I have the pack scale I used for my dad and I when we first started, but we used it with everything already packed, like our water and our food, and it was so heavy. I don't even wanna explain how much each of our packs weighed. But over here, I didn't include the weights of things that I wasn't carrying, and I only included the weights of my gear that I ended with. So we're just actually gonna go back up to the top and start with the bigger items. Here's everything that I carried from my pack and sleep system. I have my pack and that came in at about 36 ounces. Then my pack cover that I ended with is only your finest trash bag. I have, you know, my shelter, which is a Z-Pack Solplex. These usually go for about $600, but I bought it used for $400, including the tent stakes. However, the tent stakes were too lightweight for a lot of the ground on the PCT. There is some areas where there is very soft sand and dirt and soil, and the ultralight tent stakes wouldn't hold in that ground, so I upgraded to some groundhogs. Then I included my trekking poles up here because they do hold up my shelter. This item here, it's a shirt, but this just means I was wearing it, and wearing it means like I was using them while hiking, and so it wasn't something that was in my pack. If you go back up here to the weights, it has your total weight of everything. Then it has your consumables, which is like my vitamins and my toothpaste, things that just constantly need to be replenished that are AKA consumed. And then your worn weight is basically, you know, your shoes that you're wearing while hiking and your tops, and here in this case, my trekking poles. Then I use Tyvek as my ground sheet. Here I have my sleeping bag stuff sack, and my sleeping pad. So I put little notes in here that I bought this sleeping pad and then I cut it to suit for myself. Here in electronics, I started with this big battery pack, and then halfway through I wound up getting a second one about half the size. This was because I wanted to, you know, not stay in towns as much, because editing and uploading the amount of videos that I was taking up so much battery life, and so I really wanted like a second means so I didn't have to stay in towns, like I said. But I ended with both of these. This is a pretty heavy weight, you know, for electronics. Then I have my navigation, my Garmin inReach. And once again, just, I know I went over this, but if you double click, you know, open this link up, it'll take you right to this item. And if this is something that you need or you want, you know, I sent the exact link and you can just purchase it from here. Easy peasy. I have my headlamp, and then I included the batteries. It takes 4 AAAs for this headlamp, and then I always carried 4 backup. I even included the weight of my phone. I didn't include the price because that wasn't necessarily through hike related. That's something I already had and that already existed, but I did carry that. I also added my heavy duty OtterBox case that I bought for the trail, so I included the price there. I recommend getting a heavy duty phone case. I mean, you might drop your phone a lot. There's a lot of granite out there, so you just don't want your phone to break. Phone charger, and just my bag that I use to carry all of my electronics in. Clothing and shoes, you see this icon again. This is because these are all the items that I actually would wear. I put the least amount of items at the top just to be completely transparent. So I put, like, if it was beautiful weather out, that's what I said I was wearing. I wasn't trying to cheat and make my base weight smaller by saying like, oh yeah, and I'd be wearing my puffy and my long pants and, you know, all of that other stuff so that my base weight went lower. I actually just put the bare minimum. So my shoes, my gaiters, I would always wear, you know, some kind of toe socks, whether it was the liners or these socks. And then on top, I would wear a thin, like, smart wool sock. And then my hiking top, sports bra, hiking shorts, underwear, usually headband or hat. So I did put both of these. And then here we have camp shoes, my extra pair of toe socks, my sleep socks, my down jacket, my rain jacket, a mid-weight top that I would sleep in quite often, my hiking pants that I wore about half the time, my thermal leggings that I would sleep in, my gloves, and my beanie. And then down here, I bought a flannel that I ended with, but I don't have, you know, I don't have a link to it. I didn't put a picture to it. And then I have a town shirt that I bought at a thrift store and I also ended with that, so I included it here. And with these, I just estimated the weights. 8 ounces is pretty heavy, but that flannel's pretty heavy duty. So here for kitchen and water filtration, I have my Sawyer squeeze, and then my backup water purification, I had some Aqua tabs. Sometimes you would have to do 2 forms of purification because, especially in the desert, you're drinking water out of a lot of animal troughs, and sometimes there'd be like dead mice and dead lizards in there, or it was just disgusting with like a lot of algae growing on top. And so those were great times to, you know, have something like a tab. And then my Sawyer squeeze, I didn't have a stove, so I couldn't boil water, but that's another means. Here, this icon, the fork and the knife, means that it is consumable, so when you use them, obviously the weight is decreasing. My water storage were smart water bottles. You know, here the quantity, I put 3 because I typically carried 3 like 1 liter water bottles. My utensil was a Snowpeak titanium spork. I even included my cold soak jar. I didn't even carry this the whole time, but I did include it. It was just an empty Talenti ice cream jar, so that was always wonderful when you got to eat these. And Ziploc bags for my trash. I included, you know, 2 Ziploc baggies. Then I had another food bag to hold all of my food and my utensils. Hygiene and toiletries, we have Body Glide, Leuco tape, this first aid kit right here. I didn't carry this blue baggie, but I'm gonna open this up. But I did take some items out of it, and so it was really beneficial in my mind. So we're gonna go to this picture. Yeah, I like these little tweezer things right here, and then it just had a lot of great little like antiseptic wipes and aspirins and Afterbite and, you know, some moleskin. So that was really beneficial to buy, but like I said, I didn't carry that blue thing. Here is my colorful sunscreen a lot of people were confused about. They were like, what is on your face? I have this mole right here. It's like a blue dark freckle, and I really have to protect it from the sun. So I use these fun little neon colored sunscreen sticks to cover over my mole. So I would just like do this every morning, and then people were always like, what's on your face? But that's where those came from. Then I have, you know, my wet wipes, and then my hairbrush. I actually, on accident, removed all the plastic from it. It broke off, but it was great because I just had the bristles, so highly recommend that. Toothbrush, toothpaste, and then I took a lot of vitamins on trail. I took a multivitamin every day, and then, you know, a few hundred miles in, I actually picked up some magnesium pills because my cramps, especially my legs, were really bad, and this definitely helped. Magnesium also helped me sleep, so those are, you know, two pro tips right there. Some vitamin I, if I think having ibuprofen on hand or Advil or anything will be a lifesaver. I try not to take it a lot, but it's definitely something to have on hand because you may be in so much pain, your joints may hate you, but you still have to hike out 10 miles into a town. So it's kind of more for emergencies. And then some Benadryl, whether you got stung by something or, you know, just the pollen got crazy. Yeah, Benadryl was awesome. Then I also had a hygiene sack, I'd call it, that carried all of these items. And a side note for all of the pills is I never carried the bottles. I just dumped them into like a Ziploc baggie or something like that. These, I call my don't mess with me items. I've got my knife, but it was mainly for cutting my avocado and cheese. Bear spray, duct tape. A tip for the duct tape is, you know, you're not gonna carry that whole roll, but I would take the duct tape and wrap it around one or two of your trekking poles. So you have like a good amount that you can just take off as you need to use it. I never used the duct tape for myself. However, in the Sierra Nevada, actually the day I was climbing Whitney, another hiker tried to jump over this, you know, stream of water and fell and broke both of his trekking poles. And so I gave him all of my duct tape I had to try to like mend them together. So you may use it for sure. And then I had a lighter, which I never used. I didn't make any fires, but you know, it's always good to have just in case. Here is my Sierra Nevada gear. I didn't put any of the weights on it because I didn't end with it, but I did have an additional sleeping pad, my inflatable one from REI, bear canister, micro spikes, my ice axe with my ice axe leash, and then I had an additional sweater, which was very useful because you're camping at a very high elevation and it obviously is much colder. You know, sometimes I'd be at 11, 12,000 feet camping and it was just so, so cold. So I was very glad that I had an extra layer to keep me warm. But then I wound up sending all of this back home once I got out of the really high elevation. This here I labeled as my repeated purchases. Like I said, I didn't put any weights here, but these weights are reflected above with all the items that I ended with. The first pair of shoes I bought for the trail was at some like private running company in downtown Seattle, and it was like $150 for some ultra low peaks. So I definitely got ripped off. So first pair of shoes, second pair of shoes, my third pair of shoes. I swapped from Ultra Lone Peaks to Hoka 11 Torrents. I thought I liked the Hoka 11s better, but then I go back and forth between what I did like. They're both awesome shoes, but they both have completely different, you know, characteristics to them. So I'm not really sure if I had to choose today which one I would go with again, but I did like them both. They're both really good shoes. It's just feet are weird and your feet hurt no matter what. So then I bought here four more pairs of these Injinji toe socks, three pairs of these. I had bought a pair of thin darn tufts, and then I bought an extra pair of these liners. And then I bought, you know, along the trail, three different kinds of hats. With this, I just said all each of them are $30. So not the most accurate, but just, I think I overshot that for sure. So this here is my replaced gear, or my gear that I ditched during the hike. I started with this sleeping bag, which I love, but I didn't buy this sleeping bag right before the trail. I had this sleeping bag for years. I still included the price. But because I had this bag for years before the trail, in the middle of it when I was in the Sierra Nevada, I just realized that over the years it had lost too much of its insulation and I was just way too cold, which is why I bought the new sleeping bag that I ended with. And I also started with this pack cover, which I eventually got rid of, and I used a trash bag instead to hold all of my items when it was going to rain. I had the straw hat, which was awesome. I loved the sun protection, but the wind in the desert just ripped it to shreds. Windbreaker, some hiking shorts, headbands, sun gloves, and then here I had a titanium bowl, but I realized I wasn't really using it. So these are all items that I sent home at various times, or I just completely ditched. My miscellaneous items were like my prescription glasses, and I had a little compass and lightweight glasses case, and then a little wallet to hold, you know, my ID, some credit cards, cash, and my PCT permit and my California fire permit. And here I are at the bottom with my pre-hike items, which we already went through. So that was a very fast rundown. This wasn't meant to go through every item because I've, you know, posted gear stuff before, but this was just to show you literally every single thing that I purchased to thru-hike the Pacific Crest Trail. I don't think I missed anything. I might have, but this is pretty extensive. So I really hope this helps you. A little tip that I've been giving people is that the holidays are coming up and, you know, a lot of this is very expensive, you know, like your shelter or your pack. And if you don't already have these items, it's, you know, it's a big thing to just like drop on your credit card or, you know, big chunk of cash to just remove from your savings. And so I recommend asking your family and friends to pitch in for one of the big items. Like, for example, your navigational electronic item, whatever you use, I highly recommend the Garmin InReach. My parents bought this for me for Christmas, but this was $450 and this was my Christmas present and it really helped me out. Another thing is there's a lot of little items, especially like these hygiene and toiletry items. And so if you have like a little stocking stuffer, I don't know if you do that as adults, but you know, my mom still packs my sister and I little stocking stuffers. And so this is a good idea to just ask for a lot of these items. You can literally send this lighter pack to your family or friends and be like, almost like it's a registry, and just be like, hey, if you wanna get me some of these little items like these vitamins and travel size toothbrush and toothpaste or this cool little sunscreen, body glide, etc. You know, even socks, like you can finally be excited to get socks for Christmas because obviously you're gonna go through a lot and that might just really help alleviate a lot of the costs and it's presents that you actually want and you're going to use. Feel free to save this slider pack link and use it when you really are trying to plan your through hike or send it to someone that you know is through hiking. It doesn't have to be the Pacific Crest Trail. It doesn't even have to be a super long trail, but this is what I had with me when I hiked across the country. So everyone's going to have a different setup and that's okay. But this definitely I think is a great at least starting point. It's really easy to panic and think that you're forgetting something. I put everything in there. So if you go by this list, you're not gonna forget anything. Of course, like tweak it to your own like personalization, but I really hope this helped. As you can see, the costs really do add up, but usually a lot of people, especially if you've already been backpacking, have a lot of these things, but I just wanted to be as transparent as possible so you could see how much it did cost me over the years. You know, a lot of these items I didn't purchase myself, or I already had, so this number of $5,300 wasn't something that I had to front up immediately. If you are liking these videos I've been making, please like this video and comment below just so I know that I should keep making these. The next couple months actually for me are going to be quite crazy. Today is Saturday, I think October 19th, is that right? October 19th. I get married in less than a week. And then a week after that, Owen and I fly to New Zealand for 3 weeks. So definitely going to be making some videos from that trip and hopefully you all like them. And hopefully Owen and I like New Zealand. Perfect timing because I'm just about done with my coffee. that is it, everyone. Really hope you enjoy this video. Really hope that it is useful. It took me forever, just FYI. But like I said, I really just hope this helps anyone who's trying to figure out how to tackle something as big and exciting as a thru hike, especially one that's 2,600 miles long. Good luck to anyone who is planning to thru hike next year in 2020. I will be watching you guys. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already. It really helps my channel out, and it was really motivating for me to keep making videos like this. So thank you so very much, and I will see you guys later.